Welcome. Have you ever had to test a class that had dependencies where the classes were either final or had final methods in them? How do you mock those? How do you create these fake objects when you can't extend the class or you can't override the methods in the dependencies? Welcome to the latest video in the Mockito series from Tales from the Jar Side. My name is Ken Cousin, and let's take a look at this. Now, I am currently sitting at the Mockito site, mockito.org, and if you go inside the Mockito site to the javadoc.io site link that they have here, this brings us to the Mockito documentation. And the Mockito documentation is in the form of Java docs, and there's a whole series of bullet points in the Mockito class that explain how you work with Mockito. If you scroll down a bit, number 39 is mocking final types, enums, and final methods. And this has been available in Mockito since version 2.1. So if we take a look at that, they say they used to not allow that at all, but apparently enough people wanted it that they decided to add it in. Now, this capability is turned off by default. So in order to enable it, what you previously had to do was to use the so-called inline mock maker. Now, the way you enable that, the simple way is this, is instead of using the Mockito core artifact in your build file, you use the Mockito inline artifact. And there's various constraints and everything, but let's take a look at it running first, and then we'll talk about the restrictions on it. So what I have here in the book's GitHub repository is a class called PersonService. PersonService does various business logic and processing person objects that are retrieved using a person repository. So this is the class I want to mock. I want to provide a mock object for the repository that does exactly what I tell it to do, and that will enable me to isolate the service and test it. Now, the method I'm interested in here is the one called save people. Save people takes a var arg list of person objects, turns them into a stream, and here's the key, it calls save on the repository for every one of those person instances, then grabs their ID and collects them into a list and returns the list. So over here, I have a person service test, which is going to mock this, and then we'll see in a moment when I make that method final. But the idea is I want to mock that repository. Now, you may be wondering, why am I using this in-memory person repository, or if I am, why not just use it as it stands? Well, I can use it as it stands, and I have a different test to do that. And if everything passes, well, great. But again, the focus of Mockito is it allows you to isolate the problems to a particular location, and I don't want an error in my in-memory person repository to cause problems for my person service. Now, if I look at the in-memory person repository, you see that my people collection is an array list, and the save method tries to synchronize on that just in case there's multi-threading issues. So I mark that method as final. So there's our final method. Now, again, I can use this class as it is, making it a bit more of an integration test, and that's fine. But what if I want to mock this? So coming back to the test here, what I want to do is I want to mock that class and say, tell Mockito when I call save on that repository with any instance of the person class, then answer with the argument. That answer mechanism as part of Mockito will be the subject of a later video. But basically all it does is it's telling me when I put a person in as the argument of save, return that person. That's all I'm doing. So I inject the mock into the person service. I call save people with a collection of people, an array. That's basically how you call it, with a var arg list. And I check that the IDs that come back are exactly right. And I even verify that on that person repository, the save method was called with any instance of person 5 times. So this all works, but let's take a look now at Mockito versions. Now, I'm currently using Gradle's version catalog mechanism to maintain my versions all in one place. So here you see that I'm using Mockito version 5.2.0, which is current as of the time of this recording. But let me back up to the last version in the in the version 4 sequence. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to run all the tests for the book repository using Gradle, and you can see I've got errors all over the place. And in the person service test, if I look at that particular test of mocking the final method, it even gives me a null pointer exception in a place that doesn't make any sense. I mean, I know I instantiated the class. What's going on here? Well, that's the problem with trying to mock something final. Sometimes the error messages aren't even clear as to what went wrong. Now, the way the documentation said to fix that is instead of using Mockito core, use Mockito inline. And if I use that inline dependency and run again for all the tests in the repository, now they all pass. And we're good, and I don't have to change anything. So that inline mock maker allows me to fix the problem of mocking final methods and final classes. Now let me undo that, go back to the core, and in fact go back to Mockito 5. Because the big change that happened in Mockito 5 is that inline mock maker is now part of Mockito core. With Mockito 5, I can just run the test from the Gradle build and everything works. I don't have to do anything. So with Mockito 5, if you need to mock a final class or a final method, just do it the same way you'd mock anything else, and Mockito will take care of it. Now there is a caveat, and let me show you the caveat. I have a class here called Mock Final Types Tests. And in here, I am mocking the local date class from java.time. So that's local date. And I tell it when I call the toString method, then I want back the date of the original moon landing, Neil Armstrong landing on the moon and blowing his line. And I'm going to say when I call get year, return 1969, and then I do the assertion and I check that it all works, and that's fine. Or here I'm going to do something like mocking an enum. Actually, month is an enum in, again, in the java.time package, and I can set the get value method and the name method and make all of this work, and we're good. This works, but it's not a good idea for a couple of reasons. One of the reasons is you're not supposed to mock anything you don't own. And I don't own the library classes. There's a lot of risks to that. There are all kinds of reasons, and they're contained on the wiki page on the Mockito website. But let's even leave that aside. As far as Mockito is concerned, you cannot mock the wrapper classes, like integer or double as classes. You can't mock string, and you can't mock the class. So you also have that restriction as well. I have a test here which is commented out because it wouldn't work at all, no matter what you do. So your restrictions are basically don't mock things you don't own, which is a good general principle for Mockito anyway. And the other reason you don't want to mock any library classes, especially the JDK, is because when things are marked final inside the JDK, then they can do a bunch of additional optimizations. They may wind up inlining the code, and the method you call may not even be there. I mean, it's in the API, but the actual implementation has been inlined internally. It doesn't even exist anyway. So what are you doing? So within those limitations, however, as long as you're only mocking things that you wrote or your team wrote or you actually have access to as part of your system, then just use Mockito 5 and everything will work just the same way it works on anything else in Mockito. I hope you find that helpful. I hope you enjoy this video. And again, this is all covered in the Mockito Made Clear book. Please feel free to subscribe and like this video if you want to see other videos in the Mockito series. So thank you for your attention. Take care and have a good time.